Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Malcolm Farrellett, a rising senior at the St. Augustine High School, as well as a resident of New Orleans, Louisiana. And I'm here at Caesar's Palace at the National Association of Black Journalists, as well as Hispanic Journalists National Convention. And I'm here with...
Aaron Ladd. I'm a sports reporter at KSHB 41 in Kansas City. I'm actually a J-Shop alum as well. I'm glad to be interviewed.
So welcome to Vegas, Aaron. So please tell us, as a former J-Shopper, how does it feel to return back to the community that helped you nurture into what your field is now?
It means a lot, because when I first started off with J-Shop, I loved journalism, but I didn't know if it was going to be the career path for me. After Ms. Dana chewed up a couple of my stories, I really wasn't sure if it was going to be the path for me, but to see y'all, to see the program, to see everything and how it's grown just in the time that I've been through it and graduated through it, it's amazing, and I just can't wait to see what y'all turn into.
Do you see yourself as one day possibly a J-Shop mentor?
You know, if they would have me, I would love to. You know, it's a program that means a lot to me. I still have a lot of friends from that program who are in the industry, who have poured back into me, still checking with me to this day. So if they call, I would have to answer, right?
I mean, I can never say no to Dr. Hydell myself, so I can't imagine you doing either. So I know you talked about how you're a sports reporter in Kansas City. How does it feel to be a black male in a white male-dominated field, but also killing it every day that you walk on television?
Appreciate that. It's a white-dominated world. I just want to go ahead and put that out there. So you got to be comfortable in your own skin. I try to use it to my advantage. As far as sports is concerned, the locker rooms are 95% black, and 9 times out of 10, they're closer to my age than a lot of my older counterparts who have been doing it for a little bit longer. So I use that to my advantage. I ask them, hey, what you listening to? Knowing that we're probably listening to the same music. Hey, what are you doing outside the office? Knowing that we're probably in the same places outside of the office, use it to your advantage, because you never know where that can go.
And so we are back here in Las Vegas, Nevada for the NABJ convention. What are you looking forward to for this being the first in-person conference since 2019?
Been looking forward to this one for a very long time. The last 2 years have not felt the same. I like to consider myself an NABJ baby, so I come back here and just see family, see friends, you know, get some good sessions in. I'm about to head back to the career fair after this. I'm seeing Silk Sonic tonight in Vegas, which I'm really excited about, but man, I talked about this a little bit earlier, but I get so motivated from this week because I see people doing it here in our community who look like us, and it fills me up.
What advice would you have to either a current J-Shopper or someone who's attending this convention who hasn't met you yet but does have aspirations to go into your field?
Meet everybody you can here, and whether it's on camera or behind the camera, meet people, shake hands, have business cards, have different conversations, follow up on those conversations as well. Don't just get the business card and let it collect dust. Use it to your advantage, and then grow. I mean, you're going to make mistakes every day of your life. I still make mistakes to this day, and you will continue to. But learn from those mistakes, grow, and remember that passion.
So thank you so much, Aaron, for talking with us today. And that's some great advice to take. So reporting from Las Vegas, Nevada at Caesar's Palace, I'm Malcolm Farrellett, NABJ J-Shop.